to a real one. Never leave the house without the pack. Where my d- at? Take an L and try to double back. We ain't doing that. Say she mad, but I know it's cap. I've been through with that. Need someone to hype me up. Hype me up. Need someone to hype me up. Hype me up. Hype me up. Need someone to hype me up. Hype me up. Hype me up. Need someone to hype me up. Hype me up. Hype me up. Hype me up. Never turn my back on my guys when they need me. Gotta get respect for my job, it ain't easy. In a good mental state, and God is the reason. This is plain Jane season. Fresh up off the plane in Japan, I ain't leaving. They say seeing is believing. Well, here's a briefcase with $1 million even. This all week, no days off. This hard work gon' pay off. I made myself a promise young. I would never work a day job, put it in a safe. Never know when I'm gon' need that. Came here with my gang, you don't know where your homies at. Gave you a lot of game, you don't owe me back. You say you a boss, gotta show me that. Never leave the house without.
We have a cold night in the Northeast. A bad evening to be without a parka, but we are set for football at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Today, boy, what a matchup. Two NFL franchises with so much history, so much tradition, getting set to do battle here, as it'll be the Green Bay Packers taking on the New York Giants. Three quarters of the NFL season are complete. What lurks in our final month? We're underway in week 14. Kevontae Turpin now from his end zone. And not a good return here at all, as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line. Wilson going to come out throwing. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
Didn't have the greatest field position to start, did they? And now after this sack, it's way, way worse.
And right off the bat, first play of the game. Gotta hope that's not a sign of things to come as they face an early second and long. Play action. Now Wilson. Out of his hands quickly to CeeDee Lamb. So a PI call gonna cost him there defensively. What did you see?
Well, I think it's the right call, partner, because sometimes we'll see officials kind of let them play. But by the letter of the law, that's definitely a penalty.
On first and 10, it's Wilson. A throw taken in by Tyler Wallace. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. Give him 18 on that play, and Green Bay has the first as well. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On the run, this is J.K. Dobbins. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line.
Now that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've got to hit the jackpot there.
Go. Now Dobbins again on second down. They find some open field here. It's a pretty strong running there as he'll take this across the 50 and down to the 44. Give him 18 on that play, and Green Bay has the first as well.
A couple of nice carries back-to-back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare-bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time. That's what you're looking for in setting a tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive. Now Wilson on first down. And he can't get away from the pressure. The Giants get there. Arnold Ebiketie from that outside linebacker spot gets in there. It's a loss of 9. And Charles, part of the reason they lost last week, they didn't have a single sack. Well, they changed that quickly.
But did they ever? And it was something they talked about with us extensively. They needed to get pressure. How were they going to get to the quarterback? Obviously, they schemed themselves into a great play, didn't they?
On second down, a run to Dobbins. And he's going to take this one down inside the 45. 9 yards on the game there, so from second and 19, now we've got a third and 10.
We are watching a runner having a really nice game. Carrying it very well. Vision is excellent, but boy, look at the help he's getting. Offensive line, I think they're pretty eager to block for him.
Here comes the seventh play of this opening drive. They've moved it well, but here's third down. Lamb in motion left. Third down, Wilson. And this almost intercepted. Not sure he saw the free safety that time. But lucky, incomplete. That'll bring up fourth down.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
Punter J.K. Scott will send it away on fourth down. Back deep, Jakeem Grant. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air.
The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
They'll start out on the ground. It's Saquon Barkley. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop it behind the line. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
Part of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on first and second down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.
So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. From the shotgun, it's Burrow. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down. Well, that's not the way you want to start. A first pass attempt and a first drop all in one.
Well, you've got plenty of time to make up for it, but obviously not the way you want to get things started. Got to shake that off and get going.
Here we go.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. He's got his target. That's complete. Loose inside the 30. Nico Collins. Touchdown, Giants. Nico Collins. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Giants put the Knights' first points on the board as they take the early lead. They said that they wanted to get him involved early, and what a way to cap their opening drive, Charles. We know he's one of the fastest receivers in the NFL, and he showcased it on that play.
And when you have a guy like that, you want to make sure the defense sees him early, right? You want to see how they're going to adjust, how they're going to try and guard him, because they can't replicate his speed in practice unless they've got one of the few guys who are as fast as he is. And all it took was one drive, he burned them, and I think it's the last time they called his number in this one.
The kicking team out there for the Giants as they will send this one away. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. Defense got the better of them last series, forcing a punt. See if they make a few changes in the game plan here and try to get points out of this drive. First and 10. 46 yards rushing for him now to this point.
Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going and are controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. But also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
7 yards there and a first down.
I know what you're thinking out there. I know a lot of you are thinking, take a shot downfield. It's a great spot for it. I'd say maybe later in the game, definitely in the second half. But right now, I think they were just trying to get some momentum built. Get a first down, pick it up, and keep moving.
Now a late signee let go by Minnesota in June. It's Dalvin Cook. And he'll be pretty well stopped in his tracks. Give him a yard up to the 42. You talk about this Giant defense. They enter this one down in the 26th position in the NFL against the run.
And stopping the run, that's been an issue for them all season long. Aren't you glad that you're not coaching the defense right now?
I'm very glad. They said that they've seen it in doses, but very, very.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Room here to run. Down the left sideline. And they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20.
The Giants take over first and 10 at the 17-yard line.
Here we go.
This will probably be the last play of the quarter.
11, Thomas.
A first down carry for Barkley. And it'll be a minimum pickup here as it will take us to the end of the first quarter. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Ready to roll for the second quarter from MetLife Stadium. The Giants with the football as they've got it 2nd and 7. Now Burrow. Open man here is Conklin. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. First catch for him. It's good for a dozen and a first down.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover. And they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there. And now they're looking at a first and goal.
Barkley. He is going nowhere in a hurry as he is going to lose yardage here in a big way. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this day, has got to be priority 1.
on two.
So second and goal, and standing by himself in the backfield, Barkley. They're passing here, Joe Burrow. Touchdown, Giants! Tyler Conklin, a five-yard touchdown. And the Giants go up by two touchdowns. Well, that's just how they drew it up, CD. His first read was there, got it to him quickly, and into the end zone.
Absolutely excellent execution by all involved. And the coordinator, got to give him credit, found the perfect play call. Quarterback let it fly as soon as the target came free, and his guy made a nice catch. Just how you draw it up in practice and then execute it in the game.
Coup now for the point after. And it's good to make it 14-0. Kicking team out there for the Giants as they will send this one away. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it to the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay positive, but at the same time. Sheet that can work, get back to basics is usually your answer, and make sure you find the guy who can move the ball fastest for you if you just get it in his hands.
Yeah, still second quarter, you get points on the board here. I think you're feeling okay. Now it's Wilson. Open man is Denzel Mims, and he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 18 yards on his first catch of the game. It's a first down. A handoff running left is Dobbins. And some solid footwork there as he'll take this down to about the 38. 72 yards for him on the ground so far tonight as he has been terrific in this first half.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
Right back to Dobbins on first. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. 16 yards, a little deja vu from the previous play where they got 16.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. Four plays, three first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. His throw incomplete.
He didn't just deny a big throw there. He broke that one up in the red zone. An excellent play, one that may help save points on the board when this drive is over.
Second and 10. They'll run up the gut with Dobbins. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
Able to find the open man. That's complete. And the Packers are going to be set up with a first and goal as they get the conversion there on third and inches. Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in a shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. A minimal gain there on the eighth play of the drive.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
Second and goal from the one. Here's Wilson. It's complete on the bubble screen. That's Wallace. Touchdown! Tylan Wallace from a yard out. And the Packers have cut it back within a score. Joey Sly on for the extra point. And that one makes it 14-7.
Makes the score Giants 14, Packers 7.
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. On the return from his end zone is Grant. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Coming off every player's friend, the open week from last weekend.
Oh, there's no doubt about that. Even if you're coming off of a loss as they did, the open week is exactly what you need after you kind of get over a little bit, right? Rest up the mind, rest up the body, get yourself ready to go. And they have to be eager to play again, especially since they lost the last time out.
Here we go.
Throwing now, Burrow on first down. He'll get it once more into the hands of Hill. Even with that broken tackle, can't go very far. Stop short of the 30.
I don't care what sport you're playing. Everyone likes to build up a little momentum, don't they? And look at this, back-to-back completions to the big target at tight end.
That one not as profitable as the other, but still a decent game. On second down, Burrow. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. And they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line. Well, this was a 14-0 game not too long ago. Things were looking pretty good. Then you give up the touchdown on the last drive, now the interception.
So that's a lesson in trying to stay vigilant, isn't it? You have to stay on top of things. Can't relax too much because, as you noted, things change. Now they've got to go out there and get a spark going again and try and slow down this comeback.
104 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick, he's been decisive, and he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
Now Dobbins again on second down. They give him about four on the play, but he's marked short, so it'll be third and about the length of the football. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
And not only will he not get the few inches he needs, he's going to go backwards. He loses four, and it brings up four. So now on comes the field goal unit, and wow, this is no ordinary try here. He's got the leg, but it's no good. He missed it right, and this will stay at a seven-point game.
And now two problems as I see it. First, you missed the kick, which granted was a long one. But second, you set the other guys up a great field position and enough time to maybe get downfield and get a field goal attempt of their own.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And with good starting field position and three timeouts as well in their pocket, no reason not to try and put a late scoring drive together.
They have three tight ends in that formation. That's almost a universal sign that they're planning to run the football. But how about the defense there? They met force with force and caused a stack up behind the line of scrimmage and threw him for a loss.
So the offense a little antsy. The flag comes out and a five-yard penalty.
Gun.
And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Now it's Burrow. And he's got his man on the out route. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. A one touchdown ball game, 14-7 our scores. We get back at it on EA Sports. And a fair catch signaled for and taken, so they'll begin this third quarter from their 25-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. This offense set to begin the third quarter, and Charles, if they had a checklist of things they wanted to accomplish in the first half, certainly at the top of that list would be having the lead, and they've got that here.
That's always the most important box to check, isn't it? But also, they've had some success in their passing game, so probably an empty box establishing the run. They're on pace for fewer than 100 yards in this one, so now they want to make sure that they get that going. So they truly have a control in this ball game, and down the stretch, being able to be balanced, either throw it or run it, and try and win this ball game.
Here we go, here we go.
Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Burrow will throw. That's caught by his tight end, Kylan Granson. They'll wind up getting seven on the play. Brings up third and a full 10 yards.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Third down and 10. Burrow looking to pass. And he is caught. They'll have the first down and more than that. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Nico Collins. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far, as his guys are able to extend their lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Now Youngway Koo for the extra point. It's good, and it is now 21-7. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. Set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. Well, the opposition laid down the challenge, an opening drive touchdown here to start the second half. And Charles, now you feel like this group needs to get an answer because this all of a sudden is a two-score game.
Yeah, you're right about that. What was a small, manageable spread to overcome? A little bit more daunting now. I think you're exactly right. Pressure is on because you don't want them getting the ball back with a chance to really extend this lead out.
The gun, it's Wilson, and his throw is going to be incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. Now Wilson. That'll be caught. Wallace hauls it in. He's going to be taken down. Plus, there's a penalty flag in the backfield. They may get 15 more on top of this. So a roughing the passer penalty and an automatic first down.
And that's the mark of a bad team, partner, because that's an easily preventable penalty, but they just didn't take the proper steps to make it so.
After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's first and 10. Cook up the gut. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
You've got to be impressed by that defensive front on reps like those. They were not being moved off the line, kept their shoulders square, and gave their teammates time to fight to the ball and limit that gain.
Second down and 8. Mims in motion right. Now it's Wilson. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better. Got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught. They've got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
Wilson.
He's got his man. That's Wallace. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 21 yards there on third down.
And that's one of the better plays we've seen this offense put together so far. They haven't been able to get on track much at all. But listen, they're only down a couple of scores with the rest of this quarter and the entire fourth remaining. So, stranger things have happened.
On first and 10, it's Dobbins. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. He's having a big game running the football, but that one will hurt the yards per carry a little bit.
Yeah, but the average he's got so far, that's the type of average he wants to take with him to contract negotiations, doesn't he?
Third quarter from MetLife Stadium. Here's a second and 10. They go play action now. Wilson. Down inside the 10. And finally wrestled down at the 8-yard line. First target, first catch, and a first down.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. He'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal.
This is a critical sequence here for this offense. Things really haven't gone their way so far. This could be their chance to get back into it, but they've got to find a way to punch this ball in.
The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. From the shotgun, Wilson. And it's a Packers touchdown. CeeDee Lamb from 6 yards away. And the Packers have got it back to within a score. So a strong drive here to lead off this third quarter and gets them right back in this football game.
And I think we can safely call that a statement drive, because they had to be saying, we have put our best foot forward in the first half, but we certainly mean business now. Maybe a better term, a prove-it drive. They proved it to themselves that they were ready to go.
Joey Sly set to kick off.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And he returns this to the 22.
The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Here we go.
Now Burrow on first down. A short throw to Conklin, the tight end.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Here's Burrow. A little short pass here to Hill. And he's got room. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A gain of 28 yards there and give him the first down.
You don't always expect tight ends to be big in terms of run after the catch, but after that play, he joins a growing band of players that's putting that stereotype right on its ear.
So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Quick throw to Collins. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. He's certainly been a huge factor in this one. He's got the 2 touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him? Double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted.
picked off by Benjamin St. Juice. And the Packers are going to have it here at their own 15. So this offense moving the ball well, trying to open up a two-score lead here in the third quarter. But now, potentially, a play that could have big ramifications.
Yeah, you've driven the ball down the field. Things are looking up, but it takes just one bad decision to throw things off the rails.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They'll start on the ground with Dobbins. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Well, if you like the guys who run the ball, you're enjoying watching this. But the other guys, especially the defense coordinator, trying to figure out an answer on how to slow down the running game, I think maybe starts to call more blitzes, because you can call run blitzes in order to try and get more people to the point of attack.
Just need a yard here. Second and one. They'll go again with Dobbins. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. 123 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night. He continues to have a big night here under the lights carrying the football.
And some guys prefer night games. For whatever reason, their bodies react a certain way. They love the spotlight. Maybe that's what it is. The best seats in the house, the ones where he's carrying the football for his offensive teammates. The worst seats, the 11 guys trying to tackle him on defense.
And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here at MetLife Stadium. It's the Packers who have the football, but in need of points as we begin quarter number four. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. A give up the middle to Dobbins. And just 1 yard here from the 49 to the 50.
Well, how about the big guy there showing some agility? He just flowed from his D-tackle position in order to make that play.
Ball right on the 50-yard line. Here's second and 9. From midfield now, here's Wilson. That is caught by Lamb. And he's going to be taken down, but there's a penalty flag in the backfield. Is this a hold, or did they rough the quarterback? So now a fresh set of downs, first and 10 after roughing the passer. Cook following the penalty. And he's brought down. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. Good push up front and that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front. And they're able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
Dobbins. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
Back at the two now. Here's second and goal. Now they'll send a tight end in motion left. And he's got his man in stride, complete. Touchdown! CeeDee Lamb with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Packers are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth. We are set up for a fantastic finish now. A fourth quarter touchdown here. We're an extra point away from a tie football game.
And I know they're thinking about possibly going for two, but I'd go ahead and kick this one and just get it back to level.
So Slide for the PAT. And no sweat. He puts it through, and we are tied here in the fourth.
Joey Sly set to kick off.
If you've been waiting all day for Sunday night, it's been worth the wait. All tied here in the fourth as the kick is away. On the return from his end zone is Grant. And not a good return here at all as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line.
At their own 12-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They no longer have the lead after that last touchdown, all tied up in the fourth quarter, and a chance for this offense to mount a potential game-winning drive right here. And he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
That felt like a trap because it looked to me like the opposing front was on that play from the get-go. They had everyone crashing the ball carrier before he even made the line, and they hold him to just a yard.
On two, ready?
Now second and nine.
Scott.
Now it's Burrow. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. Well, that's three picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season. Because here we are in December, right? It is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake, after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
Again, Dobbins trying the right side. So a loss of five, and it'll be second down.
Well, they sent the power set out there, and their job is to be man on man and move people so they can run the football. But that time, too many men didn't get moved in the box defensively. They end up throwing it for a loss.
So a five-yard run the other way in the wrong direction, and that leads us to second and 15. Now Wilson. And that one off the mark behind him, incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Lamb in motion left. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that is incomplete.
I think it's safe to say they've made some questionable decisions out there so far. Force and throws into tight coverage. He's already been picked off in this game. Fourth down now, but he's fortunate on that one. Not got another turnover on his laundry.
Sly able to put this one through. And they have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And now they find themselves trailing following the field goal. Still a good amount of time in this fourth quarter, but this drive very well could determine the outcome of this ballgame. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two. Right there, he rose to the occasion late in a close game.
It's something he thought about, dreamed about, and worked on throughout his career. Because in these types of situations, he wasn't going to allow extra coverage to keep him from getting the football.
The second down attempt there, knocked down as it leaves the quarterback's hand, and it's incomplete.
Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'll be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
Gun. This is third and two, maybe the biggest play in this football game.
Gun.
They'll try to run for it with Barkley, and he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. 4 yards on the pickup, good enough to extend the drive. Well, they gave themselves options there on the third down play and were able to convert on that RPO.
Shows a lot of trust with the guy taking the snap, doesn't it?
Here we go.
Because you're counting on him to make the right reads and give the ball where it's supposed to go. And he did on that play.
They will throw on first down with Burrow. And that's intercepted yet again. And that could be the backbreaker. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey. And the return stops at the 39-yard line. Agreed, that's twice now in this fourth quarter.
As a quarterback, a lot of times you think it's all on you to make plays when you're losing. And here, the play's not there, but he throws it anyway.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. The center receiver in motion to the right. Dobbins trying the left side. And he gets us down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
Here's a second and three now from the 33. Another run here with Dobbins. And he struggles to get a yard here, maybe a yard, down to the 31. Well, the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
This is third and two, maybe the biggest play in this football game. They'll try to run for it with Dobbins. And he is going to have the first down, and that is going to suck the life right out of this crowd. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Dobbins running out of the gun.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. Now second and five. On the counter now, it's Dobbins. And they'll get him down right about the 20.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick. Thank you.
The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. On third down, here's Dobbins. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. The Giants going to burn their third and final timeout as they get the stoppage with 65 seconds remaining. Sly able to put this one through, and that will double their lead as it's up to 6.
So that gets him a little bit of breathing room, but not much. And you have to think back to the field goal that he missed earlier. This would be a 2-score game right now if he had converted then.
And if you and I are thinking about it, you know he is as well, because in the back of his mind, he's thinking, if I get one more shot in an important spot, he just made that one. He wants one more later to truly make up for the earlier miss.
One, ready?
This is first and 10. Burrow. That's caught by Wilson. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner. Watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know, this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there. Not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you, no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. Well, we're not seeing a confident thrower right now. He's off balance. The passing game's off balance.
It's caught inside the 25. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20.
When they've needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver it. As this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent and sometimes spectacular.
Here we go.
This offense cannot stop the clock now. No timeouts remaining as they come up here first down. Throwing, Burrow. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just talking about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
To throw, Burrow. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
With no timeouts left, that's a dangerous proposition working the middle of the field. Fortunately for them, that one fell incomplete.
If you've been waiting all day for this, this Sunday nighter's been worth the wait. It's third down here.
Stop.
Now Burrow. Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted. And he's got daylight. It's a foot race. To the end zone. It's a pick six and a Packer touchdown.
Well, somebody lit a fire under that offense during the break, Charles. Remember, they trailed at intermission. They come out, they have the big second half, and that lifts them to the victory.
And Brandon, trailing at halftime, we always talk about teams making adjustments. You know what the best adjustments usually are? It's just executing better. Because the game plan you put in place at the beginning of the week often still holds. You don't have to make wholesale changes. You just have to do it a little bit better, a little cleaner. And they did that in the second half, and that led them to victory.
So for Green Bay, their very slim playoff hopes remain as they move to 6-7 on the year. And they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for the Giants, it's unfortunately more of the same as they'll fall to 3-10 on the year. And they'll try to turn things around next week as they have a matchup in New Orleans against the Saints.
You be in your zone when you win it, on your own when you win it. Wake up, look out the window, see the rose in the Bentley when you win it. When you win it, when you win it. All you ride designer clothes when you win it. Keep up, keep when you win it. People all in your business, gotta ride with it, tenant when you win it. When you win it, when you win it. Yo, yo, she could come around but can't stick around. That's how I tease her. Been having my way since a little. Been no pleaser. Always gonna crush these souls when they realize I don't need them. I don't give a fuck how close we is. You cross the line, I'm squeezing. Every day the same routine, same, ain't no new team. Never ever had hoop dreams, but I'm balling like I want a ring. Demon time over everything, you don't know how much it really means. Struggle took a toll on them, oh, had to come and intervene. Well, them keys to that Bentley, I'm trying to drive it around. I think I'm driving it gently. Nah, I'm speeding through the town. I can't even put my phone down. Trying to show the world how it sound. Around and made the wrong turn. Struggle, I hated it at the time, but it's the reason I'm rich. Never see me knocking nobody, I know how hard it can get. Respect whoever on they, cause you be in your zone when you win it, on your own when you win it. Wake up, look out the window, see the rose in the Bentley when you win it. Cause it reeks. Oh boy, it's so much to see. Gotta learn to keep your balance. Going to sleep on silk sheets. But it used to be a pallet. Fell in love with shopping. I'm getting a grip of it. I don't need no stylist. Walking on Mars, spin a bag on anything if it got me smiling. I'm on every L that I ever took. I promise. Flashy with a sis on, man. I don't look. That's how I'm coming. Can't wait to touch a meal like I ain't got no food inside my tummy. Been had a vision. Seen it vividly before it got sunny. You could tell I'm committed. This get hard and I get it, but long as you stay authentic, you'll be destined to win it. I recreated my image. This was earned, never given. Gonna be that way till it's finished. Cause you be in your zone when you win it, on your own when you win it. Wake up, look out the window, see the rose in the Bentley when you win.
I can get it gone in a blink.
Money.
We can make a from the sink.
Money.
He can make a call if he tweet.
Black money.
I can make a ball when I speak.